since you mentioned, like, users always have the concerns, even though maybe this is a naive question, but they are concerning about if you allow more privacy or people has the option to be very private on blockchain, right? Then a lot of those criminals, they will be using the technology to conduct crimes to their advantage. And what are your takes on those issues?
Yeah, so two parts. The first one is more focused on a fallacy, and the second one is more focused on, you know, how does the regulatory landscape need to evolve to accommodate for like a true Web3 environment. Mm. So the first part about the fallacy is that you can say that about anything, mm. right? I mean, I can, you know, people invented the hammer. People have killed people with hammers, right? Like, I mean, if there's a crime to be committed, people will find ways to commit the crime, right? Yeah. And so it's not like, you know, there's no crime in the world and then we introduce a privacy solution and then all of a sudden crime emerges in the world and, like, you know, crime already exists, right? Like, there's right. already sort of like tools that people use. Right now it's all cash, yeah. right? And so the question is, should cash exist? Well, it does, right? And governments are pro-cash, so... Mm. But the question is, you know, and this leads into the second part of like the regulatory side. Like, how do you address this in a self-sovereign way? Because, you know, we have to think about it from the idea that we're not like a traditional company. Mm. It's not like we have any, it's not like the core contributors like myself have any additional access to any sort of, I guess, administrative access mm. privileges than anyone else.
Right.
We're just as, you know, powerful and powerless as every other user on our ecosystem. And
yep.
so how do we collectively as a community kind of address this in the most self-sovereign way possible?
Mm.
There's a lot of tools being developed these days. And so one of them, for example, is a viewing key. So a viewing key allows, the way a viewing key works is you have a private address.
Right.
And you do all your private transactions. But then, let's say, for example, you want to report your taxes at the end of the year to the IRS. And so you say, oh, I did this many transactions, made this much money, et cetera, et cetera. Mm. The IRS comes back and says, okay, well, you know, we need you to prove this. You can give the IRS a viewing key.
Mm.
And that viewing key allows the IRS to see all of your private transactions.
Got
but
it.
That allows the individual to decide whether or not
to
right, they
provide
want
the
to.
Viewing key to
exactly.
the authoritative party
yes.
when needed.
Or not even authorities, anyone, right?
Mm.
Like, you can provide your viewing key to anyone you want.
Mm.
So like there are definitely approaches where, you know, we're thinking about how to still provide some level of compliance and the regulatory aspects in the most adaptable way possible for like a true Web3 environment.
Yeah, I think regulation or compliance is an inevitable issue, or it's at least it's something need to be tackled by the whole Web3 industry. And
yeah.
It never hurts for founders or investors to be thinking about the issues, like how we can build the whole blockchain ecosystem together with better I'm not saying better regulation because that sounds very bad, but a proper way. Like,
yeah, adaptive regulation, right?
Yeah.
Like, you think, I agree, you have to think about the regulatory side, because at the end of the day, I don't think anyone wants, or a very minority amount of people want to build tools for criminals. Everyone else wants to build tools that can enhance value for people.
Right.
Right.
To improve efficiency, to add on values to the real world use cases.
Yeah.
We can't just live in our utopia.